I've been playing RPGs since I started gaming, with games like Custom Robo, Dragon Guard, and Kingdom Hearts solidifying the genre as my favorite from a young age, which made me less inclined to try multiplayer or online games, until Final Fantasy XIV A Realm Reborn was released in 2013. So I gave it a shot and I enjoyed it. Then I had an off and on relationship with the game, like that 1X you just can't quit, but finally at the beginning of 2021, I finally fell in love with the game. So with Endwalker less than 2 weeks away, let's talk about why this expansion is special. I think the most obvious and overly stated good point of this game is the story. Everyone knows that the Final Fantasy franchise has a reputation for giving us massive epics that span across the worlds they're set in. But with Final Fantasy XIV, it's like reading a book series like Percy Jackson, where all of the stories have their individual conflicts that are solved by the end of their respective chapters, but keep enough ongoing threads to keep us interested to see the conclusion of the series. In the gaming industry, it's common for games to get sequels, but to have one central plot going past two or three games is rare, with most falling into spin-off territory or setting future games so far before or after the original story that it might as well have been an original property. So the fact that we're getting the fifth and final part of the Hydaelyn and Zodiac saga with many great stories to be told afterwards makes me excited to continue playing this game, and is even more amazing when thinking about how 1.0 nearly destroyed Square Enix with how bad it was. It's almost like Endwalker is a confirmation that the path Creative Business Unit 3 started on in A Realm Reborn was right. The arc of this development team is similar to the story of Final Fantasy XIV itself, like rebuilding the game from the ground up, just like the Scions must rebuild a united Eorzea from the ground up after Bahamut's destruction in A Realm Reborn, or reaffirming that the path they're on is correct, just like the Warrior of Light and Alphano do in Heavensward, then navigating the rough patch of a DDoS attack, just like the Scions navigate the turbulent nature of war between Alamigo, Doma, and Garlemald in Stormblood, and most recently accepting that all of those things happened and still pushing themselves further, with them flipping the concept of darkness and light upside down in a AAA game like nobody has ever seen before. Just like the Scions adapt to a brand new world in Shadowbringers. Leading us to Endwalker, the culmination of everything the development team and the Scions have learned over the last 10 years. And regardless of how the Hydaelyn and Zodiac saga ends, there will be something waiting for everyone on the other side. But it doesn't matter how good a story is unless the gameplay is comparable to it, which in Final Fantasy XIV's case is a big fat yes. With the ability to play every job on one character, in addition to multiple difficulty levels on trials and raids, it leads to nearly endless replayability with the number of things you can do in this game, which will only expand with the release of Endwalker, with some jobs being simple and others trying to give you sensory overload with how many things you need to keep track of. There's something here for all of us regardless of what mood we're in, with Reaper and Sage adding on to the things I just mentioned. And I could just be looking for some meaning when there isn't any, but I think it's symbolic that the two jobs added in this expansion are so relevant, with Sage is usually being very knowledgeable and Endwalker drawing upon the previous experiences of the development team, then Reaper's signaling the end of life, just like this is the end of the story started back in 2.0, leaves me with a feeling that's hard to describe, but I feel many of you understand. So I'll end my rambling by saying enjoy your time in a pre-Endwalker world, and get excited for what comes next, because in this day and age we usually don't see stories reach their natural conclusions, with all types of media getting cancelled, axed, or getting fucked over by some random executive who thinks they know better than the people who they hired. It's just amazing that Final Fantasy XIV has reached this point, because at this point, do we really have any big reasons to doubt the devs at this point, with them handling the massive influx of players that have joined this year, willingly delaying the game 2 weeks before its initial release to make sure the product is polished to perfection when we get it in our hands? Personally, I don't think so. In my opinion, Endwalker is just a victory lap for Creative Business Unit 3. Also, at the end of the day, Yoshi RCP holds all of our souls in his hands and will like it anyway. But with that being said, if you enjoyed the video, like, comment, and subscribe with notifications turned on. If you want to see more videos like this one or recap videos like the one I uploaded about Final Fantasy XIV last week, and what are you most excited to do in Endwalker? But it's been Skipx and I'm out.